Gwen Grant was a coal miner's daughter born in Worksop.
Yeah.
She's now a successful children's writer who regularly visits local schools to encourage youngsters in their writing.
So I think we ought to hear them talking. Yeah? Okay.
When I started writing my first book, I automatically went to my roots and I wanted to write about a world that was passing far too rapidly. I wanted to capture that world so it didn't go altogether. The odd thing about it is I get letters from children and they don't seem to see any difference between that world and this world. The books seem to talk to them directly. There doesn't seem to be that intervening 30 years, 40 years really.
And they've got these long, long
branches.
Like
witches' fingers, yeah. There's a kind of magic that comes about when you're working with children. The actual writing seems to exert a kind of magic itself, which I've always put down to God. In my life, the creativity I know has always stemmed from God, and that's my magic. That's where I get my joy and my peace from. They just seem to respond to the joy, to the creative joy of working, but not working in any frivolous way, working in a serious and committed way. And that, I think, is where God comes into it. There is no waste. There's a total commitment of effort.
The children in this particular village come from a community where the pit has closed and there's been quite a depression in the area. What does the love of God, that is so much the theme of your books, mean to children like them?
For me, it released me from being bound by poverty or being bound by your background. I didn't have to be what I was destined to be. When I go into schools, when I speak about what I am, where I've come from, I would hope that that promise of Christ comes through to them, and that with me, they find the joy of working in Christ, and they'll take that home, and it'll stay with them.
It's quite clear from meeting you that your love of God is absolutely central to your life.
Yes, that's why I've chosen the hymn, "O Love That Will Not Let Me Go," because God has never let me go. Even when I've wanted to go, he hasn't let me go, and now I don't want to go.
Oh,
Neil Renshaw is consultant anaesthetist at the local Bassetlaw Hospital.
Yes, so we're going to have to pull this down a bit. About...
I personally have a special interest in long-standing pain, chronic pain, which is looking after people who have been in pain for months, even years. And many of these people will have had illnesses which have long since been treated as far as possible, but the pain has remained. And a few of our patients have had no obvious diagnosis made despite lots of investigations. And a few also will be in pain as a result of previous medical or surgical treatment that they've had. And we try our best to help these people as far as possible.
What possible treatment is there for that kind of pain?
It's definitely a team effort. We have doctors, nurses, physiotherapists involved, and colleagues in x-ray departments and so forth, and in the pathology lab. And we have various methods of treatment. We have physical methods, such as acupuncture and related things, electrical treatments. We have treatments with tablets and medicines of various kinds. And we also treat pain with certain types of injections. These involve injections sometimes into the painful area, sometimes into the nerves which go to that part of the body, and occasionally around the spine and around the spinal cord in order to try to modify the way in which the spine and the brain handle that, the pain information coming to them.
Do you think that prayer has a role to play in the healing process?
For those people who have the gift of faith, most certainly, yes. I know that many of my patients pray regularly by themselves and also with their friends and the ministers or priests or whatever church they belong to. And there's no doubt in my mind that all prayers are heard and they're all responded to in one way or another. And I have seen patients who have got better, I'm sure for no other reason than through prayer. And some of them have got better so much that they've really not needed my services at all anymore, which is great because prayer has no side effects, unlike my treatments.
Now, have you chosen a hymn which has a special meaning for people in pain?
Yes, I have. I've chosen Be Still My Soul, The Lord Is On Your Side, which can be a joyful hymn of praise if we're feeling well and healthy, or if we're feeling ill or in pain or whatever, it can be a quiet act of trust in God, and it contains that wonderful line, the tempests still obey his voice who first they heard on Galilee, that the age of miracles is not past.
Let us pray. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you and those you love this night and forevermore. Amen. Amen.
If you enjoyed the video, hit the like button. I really do appreciate it. If you haven't already subscribed, then now's a great time to do it. And don't forget to hit the notification bell to make sure you don't miss a thing.